Introduction to microwave bench setup and component. The purpose of this lecture is to identify the microwave component after seeing the physical component in laboratory. The microwave range from 300 MHz to 300 GHz. In terms of wavelength, if you are calculated 1 meter to 1 mm. The component used constructed using the conductive material such as your copper. Also brass and copper. The component is painted outside. Inside use silver and gold plated inside your component. Okay, move to your introduction part. This is your block diagram of microwave bench setup. If you see here, the klystron, first one is the klystron power supply, then this connection goes to klystron mount, then connection goes to isolator, then component connected to variable alternator and frequency meter. Next one is the slotter section, and in slotter section VHWR meter is connected and end of your load or by using mass termination. The klystron power supply you see here, this is your klystron power supply, and next your klystron mount tube. This is your klystron, this cylinder shape you see here, we zoom it. This is one klystron tube. Next one is your isolator is this section, your isolator. This one is the isolator and variable attenuator. This one is the variable attenuator, and next one is the frequency meter. This is your frequency meter. You also interchange this, there is nothing problem. You use such like way. Other one is the slotted section. This one is your slotted section. And next one is the VHWR meter. This lock or VHWR meter. Next one is the load is terminated. This section. Okay, one by one we study their property. The klystron power supply. And this is one of the klystron power supply image. Klystron power supply plus klystron mount tube. By using both block, we generate the particular mod in our rectangular waveguide. Means this is a supply connection. Using this supply, we are connected to klystron tube. Both combined, then particular mod is generated inside your rectangular waveguide. This is a rectangular waveguide. The shape like rectangular shape, that's why its name is the rectangular waveguide. Is circular shape, then waveguide is called circular waveguide. Okay, this one is the klystron power supply image. You see here the knob, also the knob different. You see here repeller voltage and beam voltage and beam current. You also perform when experiment, you also explain this, what use this one. Okay, just you focus. This is your klystron power supply. Next your klystron mount tube. This one is the klystron mount. Klystron mount means you connect the klystron tube here. This one is your klystron tube. Klystron tube is connected in your klystron mount. The combined form is called klystron mount and klystron tube, klystron mount tube. Okay, next one is the rectangular waveguide. You see here the rectangular cross section area. This one is the rectangular cross section here. That's why called rectangular waveguide. Waveguide means a hollow metallic tube. A metal formation, hollow metallic tube that carry a signal from source to load. Suppose source is available here, source to load. Load is here. The signal pass through this hollow pipe. This section you see here, the length, width and height. So this is the width and this is the height, dimension of rectangular waveguide. Next one is the isolator. Isolator is the two port device. One port, to look here, suppose input waveform is given inside. From suppose this side is source and this is your output side. signal go inside in your isolator. The purpose of isolator is the signal flow only one direction and block signal in other direction. Means block means if suppose there is a reflection from load side, then this is absorbed, not move in source side. The reflected signal not move to source side, means to save a source signal. That's why isolator flow only one direction. Isolator, you see here isolator used in microwave band setup. This is your isolator, means signal flow only one direction. This direction signal flow, suppose there is a reflection, then isolator is blocked. Next one is circulator. Circulator is 3-port device. This is your 3-port device. The working of circulator etc also in a study in upcoming your lectures. Just you see here, this is your 3-port device. Suppose be given the port 1, then next output come to second port. Suppose be input apply second port, next output come your third port. Working also understand in a theory part. Okay, we move to your variable attenuator. Variable attenuator, you see here is the, this is your rectangular waveguide. Attach a attenuate a signal or wave. Suppose inside your signal flow or wave supported signal is flow, then if the amplitude are decreases by routing these node, that's why this name is the variable attenuator. Suppose there is fixed attenuator, then there is nothing any rotational part in your attenuator. After rotating this node, you decrease your amplitude of signal. Next one is the frequency meter. By using, this is the cavity rectangle, is cylindrical cavity. Actually this is a cylindrical cavity. You see here, by using frequency meter, we measure the microwave frequency. You see here, this is your horizontal line, two horizontal line and one is the vertical line. You see here, this is your dark line. This is your one dark line and second one dark line. These are the horizontal line. One, you see here, one is the dark line, is the vertical line. When we go to the measure your frequency, microwave frequency, then after the coincidence between these scale, then you measure your frequency. In upcoming your lab experiment, you see here when we go for frequency measurement. Next, move to the slotted section. This is your of the slotted section. The purpose of slotted section to measure your VSWR inside your rectangular waveguide using a detecting instrument. Detecting instrument means, you see here, this is a rectangular waveguide. You see here, there is cut between center. This, you see here, there is cut between center. In center, we use a tunable probe to detect the standing wave pattern inside your rectangular waveguide. Tunable probe is used to detect your standing wave pattern. This one is the tunable probe. Actually, inside your center cutting point, inside this point is in your slotted section, and to detect a microwave signal. Next, you see here slotted section and attached with the tunable probe. Next one is the VSWR meter. Using VSWR meter, we detect or measure VSWR. voltage standing wave ratio or standing wave ratio. There is different probe to set a gain a particular mode. You see also in instrument, load is the end of your microwave band setup. Actually, this is a mesh termination, means whatever your signal flow inside your waveguide, that is mesh to end of our waveguide termination. Also observe the microwave power, the load. The E plan T, it 3-port device, it alphabet like T form, that's why also name is given to E plan T. You see here, it is a 3-port device, port 1, port 2 and port 3. The electric field is port 3 is parallel to port 3, that's why also name is E plan T. This is one main waveguide and one of the side arm is attached with this one. Working etc, you understand in upcoming your theory lecture, live lecture. Next one, S plan T. You also see here similar like E plan T, it also a 3-port device. You see here E and H plan T. You see E plan T and S plan T. In this E plan T, electric field is parallel to side arm. Suppose this is the collinear arm, means main arm, also called main waveguide arm. This is one side arm. The E plan T, in E plan T, the side arm is parallel to electric field. That's why E plan T. In S plan T, H field, you see here, H field is parallel to side arm. Yeah, or H arm. That is S plan T. Suppose we give the input port 2, then output come port 1 and port 3. In equal magnitude, in port 2 given input, divide in equally port 1 and port 3. Equally and opposite it 180 degree phase shift. In this S plan T, suppose we given input port 2, then also divide in port 1 and port 3 in equal magnitude and same phase. Here 180 degree phase shift, port 1 and port 3, one given to input port 2. This is the E plan S plan T. Next one is the magic T. This is combination of E and S plan T. The property is also like your E and S plan T. The working also study in the next upcoming experiment lab. This one is your ES plan T or magic T. You see here port 1, port 2 and port 3 and port 4. Next one is the direction coupler. Direction coupler used purpose for dividing or coupling one waveguide to other waveguide. This is 4-port device. You see here port 1, port 2, port 3 and port 4. Here port is mesh terminated through mesh load. You see here, this is the 4-port device. Input port, transmitted port are 1 port, 2nd port, 3rd port and 4th port. You also see working upcoming lab lectures or theory. Okay, today in your lab experiment of introduction of microwave component.